I finally answered it myself. Not pleased, not pleased at all. Where's Flannery? Back to work! Not so fast, John. I want a word with you. Alone.
Another crisis, Mr. Graydon?
A big one, John. That last batch of carbon paper was not the snuff. Write a memo to the head of supplies. Read his beads.
Read beads?
Pin his ears back.
Pin ears.
Really go after him.
Really go after him. Oh, Mr. G.
Who?
You. Do you have a mo?
A what?
A moment. I would love to get a man's opinion of Rudolph Valentino.
Okay.
I mean, in the sheet, he takes Agnes Ayres by brute force. And she enjoys it. She enjoys it a lot. So, Mr. Graydon, what is your opinion of brute force?
I'm not for it. Not for it at all. That's not what a woman wants these days. These days, a young woman wants someone she can trust, a Tom Sawyer at 20.
I never read Tom Sawyer. Was he sexy?
He was 12.
Well, if you got it, you got it.
I got it.
You have to talk about last night.
In case you didn't get the message by my slamming the phone in your ear, let's forget last night ever happened.
You can't be serious.
Leave her alone!
What? Oh, lovely elbows you've got, Miss Flannery.
From my mother's side of the family, the Bronx girls were always noted for their elbows.
Well, I can see why.
My Barney was always partial to them. But then, you and he are so much alike. Get out! She never wants to see you again!
That can't be true!
You better believe it, Mr. Man!
Millie!
Thank you, Miss Flannery. Peg.
I hate to bother with the office, but...
More research on how the other half lives? I think I got a taste of it myself last night.
At Mother's party, you mean? Oh, wasn't it heaven? Who knew how soon I'd be plunged into the depths of Hades?
Funny thing about remorse.
Oh, Millie, I feel so dirty. You had this peculiar grin on his face as he went to shake my hand. Only it wasn't my hand he wanted to shake. He
pounced!
I couldn't breathe!
He takes your breath away!
I felt it in the pit of your stomach!
My legs buckled! No wonder you couldn't stop him! And for all you knew, I was going to marry my boss!
You mean you're not?
I most certainly am! Oh, Miss Dorothy, promise me that no man will ever come between us.
As if anyone would take the place of my best friend.
Oh!
But what has this got to do with my audition for David Belasco?
Oh, that was this morning! How did it go?
Fine, until he pounced.
Him too? Boy, you've really been through it.
Do I look like the sort of girl who would allow a man to take liberties?
You look helpless, which is even better as far as men are concerned. They think they can get away with it. Well, take a page from my book, Miss Dorothy. Callous up. Higher heels, shorter skirts. And you're not going to like this. Cut your hair.
Cut my hair?
No more little girl lost in the lion's den. What I'm offering you is the fashion equivalent to a whip and a chair.
Tame the beast.
No time like the present, Miss Dorothy.
John, make an old scout and ring up my handball court. Reserve a court for 6:15, will you?
Yes, sir.
Gotta work up against sweat. Edgy in the gut, tight in the... Ah, sweet mystery of life, at last I found thee.
Handball court for 6:15.
I know at last the secret of it all.
Handball.
Very strange feeling I have felt before. It's a kind of a grind of depression.
My heart's acting strangely, it feels rather sore. At least it gives me that impression.
My pulses leap madly without any cause. Believe me, I'm telling you truly.
I'm gay without pause and sad without cause.
My spirits are truly.
Bronx.